So makeup for me is actually an expression of your style and who you are. So for instance, let's say you're maybe just a stay-at-home mom. You know, it reflects, whatever you're wearing reflects who you are and enhances who you are. Maybe you're an aspiring model, you know, who loves color. So maybe you wear colors that are bolder. Maybe you enjoy bright, bold lips, you know. Or maybe you're a high-powered CEO of a company, you know, so it's a little bit more classic. Maybe you just rock the black wing liner. But with that being said, makeup is an extension of who you are. So for me, as a makeup artist, I love color. I love color in my hair. I love wearing bright colors. But there's also days where I kind of change. So, and that also happens as well. So sometimes my mood is like bold and bright, so I rock the bold and bright colors, and sometimes it's just subdued. I rock neutrals and nude tones, but anyway, so it's just something fun to play with. I always think of makeup as being an accessory. So if you think about it, accessories can be something simple that just add a little flair to your outfit, to your look, to your style, or it can also be something that's very, very bold, big, gaudy bling, you know, like I said, whatever I'm feeling for that moment or that day is how I choose what I'm going to wear. The most important thing is be comfortable with what you decide. Have fun, try something new. If you haven't ever worn a red lip color, try to rock it. One thing I tell my clients is this: when you're given an opportunity to try something new, do it. If you cannot handle a red, wear it for the rest of the day. If you still can't get used to it, then go ahead and choose something different. But ultimately, you know, give it a try, try something new. You know what, I am a huge advocate of healthy makeup. Through the years, as my life has kind of transitioned into this more fit, healthy lifestyle, I've done a lot of research on cosmetics. And I will tell you that the majority of the cosmetics that are out there that we buy are actually pretty toxic. I know some people don't care about that, but I do. And so now that I'm aware of it, my focus is providing cosmetics and makeup that is actually as free from toxins as possible. And what I found is that most mineral makeups that are true mineral makeups are actually the best for your skin. Because if you think about it, your skin is the largest organism on your body. Everything is absorbed from the skin into the bloodstream directly. So it's really, really important to be mindful that those toxins are going to infiltrate and go into the bloodstream. So for me, again, I love mineral makeup. And if you are health conscious, if you are concerned about carcinogenics or things that can cause cancer, because they do, be mindful, read the labels, do your research. And look at the ingredients. They will tell you. There are companies out there that are you can Google that will give you information on certain products that are higher in toxicity than others. So again, my personal preference is to utilize mineral makeup that is as free from toxins as possible.